All right. Now let's talk about the president's order to ban
Yes.
pogos. You were quite emotional on that. I saw the interview after the sauna. And I believe you did say how you appreciated the president's order. So I wanted to ask you this. I interviewed Bagcor Chair Al Tengko and he is lobbying that so far there are 12 SBPOs. This is outside the 43 IGLs. No, he did say that POGO and IGLs, all of them banned.
Yes.
They all have to go. But he said there are 12 SBPOs that in effect, there's no gaming, but they service gaming. No? And he claims there are 10,000 Filipinos there. There are another six companies applying for SBPOs. There's no gaming, but he says Filipinos who do assist international gaming, gives customer service. He's asking the president to spare that. What do you think?
Mabuti na lang hindi binanggit ni Chair Tengko yan sa hearing namin because I would also have taken issue with that. In fact, both he and lalo na si Sol Jen Menardo Guevara in our recent hearing said napaka-unequivocal ng pag-ban ni Presidente sa POGOs. Kaya hanggang ngayon sinasabi ko, goodbye POGO! Legal man kayong nagsimula o illegal, malaking tagumpay ito sa bayan, Karen, na binan sila. Effective July 22, ordered to wind down until the end of the year at iniutos nga din yung just transition para sa lahat ng nagtatrabaho doon. So, babantayan namin ng mahigpit. There should be no attempt to reinterpret yung klarong-klarong sinabi ni Presidente. Sabi nga ni Sol Jen Guevara, walang qualifications. Kaya huwag dapat may mag-lobby ng anumang exemption or exceptions. Pati nga po yung mga special economic zones ay kasama lahat. Yung mga nagkakaroon ng gaming sa loob pero sa visa ng PAGCOR licenses. Oh, in fact, Karen, those PAGCOR licenses are all-powerful even now, even in terms of implementing the ban. Kasi wala namang batas para sa POGO, those were made to operate under a simple policy of Duterte, an EO. So we don't even need to wait for a law to be passed against POGOs. Simpleng kanselahin, without exception, kanselahin ang PAGCOR yung mga lisensya, and that should fulfill the in full obedience no ng buong executive, that should fulfill, that should follow the order of the president contained in his sauna ban on POGOs.
Oh, but do you consider SBPOs as POGOs? So I guess there's special BPOs. Do you consider them as POGOs?
Well, Karen, unfortunately for the champions of POGO, at this point in time, as far as POGO, IGL, or anything that could be POGO, this is a case of guilty until proven innocent. And anything that is being appealed for during this time na winawind down natin at completely banned ang POGOs, I would say still in principle are covered by that POGO ban of the president. And in fact, sinabi rin ni PAGCOR Chair Tengko na starting with PAGCOR's meetings with DOLE and other government agencies, meron din silang, magkakaroon sila ng isang plan of action, very detailed in time, a timetable until the end of the year to wind down, including studying any problematic areas covered by any individual charters, in order to effect that total ban on POGOs, IGLs, and any other POGO-like entities that are in essence POGO pa rin, di ba?
Okay. Now, related to that is, let's go to CESA. Interestingly, even before 2016, even before President Duterte's EO, CESA, this is the Cagayan Economic Zone,
authority.
Right? Authority, already had iGaming or interactive gaming. So Katrina Ponce Enrile, the head of CESA, in the hearing said that they have no POGOs, they have no POGOs, but they have had iGaming. So it turns out that overall, the Philippine Economic Zone Authority has already issued 17,000 visas to foreigners since 2021. Katrina Ponce Enrile says they've been regulating and licensing iGaming for more than 20 years. So the question now is do you consider that iGaming should be retained and that is different from the banning of POGOs in general?
Unfortunately, offhand, Karen, iGaming sounds very close to IGL, which was the rebranding, changing of nomenclature and acronym, mere changing of acronym and nomenclature of POGOs. So these could be evolutions lang of one and the same thing. Baka pare-parehong animal lang ang iGaming dati na naging POGO sa mahabang panahon na recently na rebrand bilang IGL. And if pag Court Chair Tenko said ang IGL ay pareho lang sa POGO kaya subject sa POGO ban, it is reasonable for us to inquire and sinabi namin sa PAGCOR nung nakaarang hearing, alamin din, hindi kaya't itong naunang iGaming ay ibang iteration lang ng POGO. 17,000 visas is no joke. That is a lot of people. So kaya sa nakaraang hearing namin, sinabi din ni PAGCOR Chair Tenko, pag-aaralan din nila pati yung charter ng CESA. And I hope that ang magiging direksyon ng pag-aaral na yon ng PAGCOR in partnership with other government agencies is to strictly enforce the POGO ban of the President kahit pa ito ay laban sa malapogo, kung mapatunayang malapogo na iGaming sa isang naunang export zone authority, no?
Oo. Because that's the irony is prior to POGO, iGaming has existed but it was in effect, how do you say that, it was isolated, right? Mm-hmm. That's the right term. It was more controlled. In mm-hmm. other words, all activities related to iGaming were inside the special economic zone. But what mm-hmm. happened when the president issued the EO, reports mm-hmm. have said that from just being in CESA or PEZA, they've already come to the skyscrapers of Metro mm-hmm. Manila. Mm-hmm. Now, I wanted to ask you, a United Nations document, the United Nations Office on Drugs and Crime, this is a UNDOC document, this 2024, says mm-hmm. that CESA isn't completely faultless, that there is a criminal syndicate mm-hmm. that is linked through layers of companies to an online casino, mm-hmm. which the group is in CESA. So mm-hmm. my next question is, will there be a deeper investigation on CESA? But you have Katrina Ponce and really already declaring there is no POGO in mm-hmm. CESA and they are against POGO.
The PAGCOR with the other government agencies should take cognizance of that UNODC document. Yeah. Kasi sa isang naunang hearing din namin, the UNODC resource person said, although hindi pa tayo kasing lala ng Mekong River Delta region countries, binabantayan na rin nila yung nangyayari dito sa Pilipinas. Kumbaga, we are already a cause for concern, a cause of concern for them. Tsaka kasi yung migration ng mga POGOs, hindi lang geographical, Karen. The internet is a whole new country through which they are able to migrate. Kung nung panahon ng mga unang export processing zones or export zone authorities or special economic zones, wala pang internet. At akala siguro ng iba kaya nilang kontrolin. That matter of control is out of their hands because the internet, social media, that is a whole new country na pati yung sistema doon ginigame na ng mga POGO and POGO-like entities at ng mga criminal syndicates na talagang nanuot doon. No? So I hope that PAGCOR will study without fear or favor sino-sino pa man ang may association sa kahit alinmang POGO or POGO-like entity enforce, no? In full with full obedience yung ban ni Presidente laban sa lahat ng POGO, IGL man ang tawag dyan, or kung mapatunayang ang iGaming kasama dyan, lahat ng POGO o malapogo ban.
Oo. And I wanted to ask you, so There's actually, I believe it was explained, no? Chairman Altenko explained it, the difference of POGO, which is offshore, and PIGO. So PIGO, everything local that involves online, it's bingo, etc., and other games that are essentially played by Filipinos. In
Yes.
an ideal, in an ideal world, there should be no gambling, but there is. So I want to ask you, what is the difference for you between POGO and PIGO, and why should PIGO be more tolerated than POGO?
I haven't thought as much about PIGO, kaya hindi ko pa masabi kung dapat ba siyang mas itolerate o hindi. Basta't ang klaro sa akin is may tagumpay na tayo dito laban sa POGO, you know, a policy ban against it. Ng isang presidente sa State of the Nation address niya. So, kumbaga yung nagbunga na yung apat na taon nating investigasyon laban sa mga POGO. Yung mga advocates against gambling in general, they too should appreciate na malaking tagumpay ito. At kung itutuloy nila yung advocacy nila laban sa lahat ng klase ng gambling, they will probably use this as a building block or a resource. Pero para sa akin, these months until the end of the year, ang priority talaga, ang urgent talaga ay mapatupad yung ban na yan. At masiguro na walang bago o dati ng mga entities that actually fall under the shadow of POGO na hindi maban, hindi mapatigil ang operation.
All right, now let's move on to Pastor Apollo Quiboloy, another fugitive who's been in hiding now for many, many months. Just recently, the Philippine National Police relieved 15 police officers for failing to arrest Apollo Quiboloy. However, the PNP is also criticized by Quiboloy supporters for using what they say is excessive force. What do you think of this allegation?
That is an overstatement. I believe nung pinasok ng PNP yung Glory Mountain or yung kingdom ni Apollo Quiboloy, it was to effect the warrant of arrest. Tatlo na ang warrants ni Apollo Quiboloy dito lamang sa Pilipinas. Dalawa mula sa Korte at isa mula sa Senado. In addition to that, he is the subject of cases in the United States. Apat na kaso din doon na umaandar hanggang sa ngayon. And those will eventually catch up with him, lalo na kung ma-issuehan na rin siya ng warrant sa bisa ng mga kaso ngayon. Pag nailagay pa siya, Karen, sa red list ng Interpol, hindi lang iisa o dadalawang law enforcement agencies ang hahabol sa kanya. And here also on the Philippine side, as far as I know, law enforcement agents are still on the hunt for him. So, you know, just to save us all the trouble, dapat magpakita na lamang siya sagutin yung mga akusasyon laban sa kanya. The PNP is simply fulfilling their mandate as the primary public order institution in our country.
All right, let's talk about the ICC just before we go. Nobody's seen the document formally yet, but former Senator Antonio Trillanes says that former President Duterte, Senator Bato de la Rosa, former PNP Chief Oscar Albayalde, I believe two or three others, are in the list as suspects, or is it called blue notice? I'm trying to remember, okay? But they're in effect in the list as suspects related to the investigation on the drug war. The Solicitor General says he hasn't gotten the document, but has received the same information. Your thoughts on this?
The ICC investigation ay isa sa pinakamatagal na at pinaka matindi at taimtim na inaasahan, lalo na nung mga widows and orphans ng so-called war on drugs. Napaka-importanting proseso na mapanagot si Duterte sa sinasabing hanggang tens of thousands na extrajudicial killings. And this administration has had a colored or flip-flopping position on the ICC nung simula, sinabing hindi pa dadaanin, pero sinabi pagkatapos nun pinag-aaralan kung babalik na tayo sa active participation sa International Criminal Court at pag-uphold ng Rome Statute. So paiba-iba, pero nitong huli, mukhang nagiging mas consistent yung mga small signals, but signals nonetheless, simula sa DOJ noon na not out of compliance but out of courtesy and out of committee, pag may hiningin dokumento sa kanila, ibibigay nila. Hanggang dito nga sa pinaka-recent na sinabi ng Solgen na bagamat hindi active na tutulong, papayagan kung kequestionin ng ICC yung mga iniimbestiga nila. So this is a very long, very difficult, painful process, but painful mostly for the bereaved families of the EJK victims. I really hope, Karen, na magpatuloy itong proseso, observing all the due process standards, of course, leading towards accountability and justice para sa lahat.
Okay, my last question on the ICC issue is, you've said that this administration has flip-flopped. Do you see this administration as using the ICC issue as a political means, given that the Dutertes are their biggest opponent in the upcoming elections? When there was Unitim, the president has stood and said that we will not cooperate with the ICC. And you have pundits saying now that the Unitim has broken. You have the administration saying this. We don't believe in the ICC's jurisdiction, but frankly, we can't help it if they're here investigating, etc. It's a completely different tune. What are your thoughts? Is this administration sincere in seeking out justice for the victims, putting Duterte really to face trial, or is it really just a political means to an end?
I think itong issue ng ICC, bagamat it's one of the most important issues on which the former Unitim is singing different tunes, way beyond politics na ito, Karen, kahit para sa administration, tingin ko. Kasi sila rin, they have their own doubts and deep discomforts about it. Kaya nga, naging paiba-iba yung position at statements nila from the start until more recently. Pero palagay ko, kahit yung administrasyon, nakikita niya na wala siyang kawala eh. Kung gusto niyang ibalik sa mas maayos na pagtingin ng mundo sa buong bansa natin, hindi lang sa sarili nila, sa administrasyon, they have to show, just as in the West Philippine Sea, dito rin sa ICC, yung pag-comply natin sa mga international standards, whether of rule of law at sea o sa usapin ng international law. So I think wala silang kawala dyan, and sa ayon man nila o sa hindi, whether or not issue ito on which banggaan talaga sila ng mga Duterte, I suppose it is inevitable, with or without, but better with the cooperation of the administration, palapit talaga tayo sa full-blown process ng ICC dito sa Pilipinas.
Okay, my last question on this is more personal. I think in social media, you've been getting a lot of congratulations, essentially for the work that you have done investigating POGOs. Actually, the Alice Go discovery was accidental, right? In the hearing, when you're investigating POGOs, that's the irony. She wasn't being investigated at all until she suddenly couldn't answer basic questions. And then it became about her role, right? So I think overall, is the president heard you, the clamor of the people, also there's Senator Sherwin Gatchalian's work. In the lower house also, you have anti-POGO advocates, but clearly the work that you have done nonstop, and considering you didn't have a lot of support from your other colleagues in the beginning, but you did it regardless of whether or not your colleagues supported you. I think overall, it's just important to put this out here. What are your thoughts in terms of being a public servant, a senator? Because this is a big victory for someone like yourself who's been doing the work, right? Sometimes there's no recognition, there's no effect, but other times in moments like this, the victory just smells so sweet on your end.
And I think marami tayo, Karen, na inaamoy yung sweet scent of victory na yan. Kasi talagang hindi lang kami na nasa zona noon nung binani presidente ang Pogo ang pumalakpak, nag-standing ovation. I felt marami
na
kapayan natin din. Oo. So it's a great vindication for the Senate, yung mga anti-Pogo counterparts din namin sa House. Some of them 4 years ago, they already filed a bill or a resolution against POGOs. Nitong huli, meron din silang investigasyon sa POGOs at may na-establish kahit kay Attorney Roque. Ito ay higit sa lahat tagumpay ng lahat ng mga matatapang na victim survivors at whistleblowers at witnesses, no, na who staked a lot, some of them even their lives, to tell the truth against POGOs. Tagumpay din ito ng mga government agencies na over the years mas tumulong na sa amin, yung IACAT ng DOJ, yung NBI, yung AMLAC, at marami pang iba. So it's a great vindication for the Senate. It's a vindication for the Senate Committee on Women. Apat na taon ng sama-samang pagtatrabaho has really borne fruit. It shows that investigations in aid of legislation can shine the light, inescapable light on those who should be held to account. It highlights yung mga victim survivors who deserve a measure of justice. It instructs us na mga legislators ano dapat ang mga ina-amend or i-repeal or bagong batas na dapat likhain. So masaya talaga ako hanggang ngayon, hindi pa nabawasan yung saya at ginhawa na dulot nitong pag-ban sa POGOs.
All right. Well, congratulations to you too. And we appreciate you coming back to Head Start. Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you very much.
All right. Senator Risa Ontiveros, thank you.